Paul versus Bar Jesus, aka Elymas. We all know who wins. God bless you guys. Today's a new topic today, where we go into Paul versus Elymas, aka Bar-Jesus. For those of you guys who don't know, Elymas was a magician and a false prophet, and he was leading the proconsul astray until Paul comes in the name of Jesus. So we start in the book of Acts chapter 13, and we're going to read from verse 1 to 12. So if you guys will follow along with your Bibles, let's read on. Now there were in the church of Antioch prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, a lifelong friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then after fasting and praying, they laid their hands on them and sent them off. As they were united, the Holy Spirit spoke and said for Barnabas and Saul to go, that they have work to be done that he called them for. And so everyone fasted and prayed and laid their hands on them and then sent them off. So being sent by the Holy Spirit, they went down to Seleucia, and from there they sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived at Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in synagogues of the Jews, and they had John to assist them. When they had gone through the whole island as far as Paphos, they came upon a certain magician, a Jewish false prophet named Bar-Jesus. He was with the proconsul Sergius Paulus, a man of intelligence, who summoned Barnabas and Saul and sought to hear the word of God. So this proconsul, Sergius Paulus, he actually summoned them so he can hear the word of God. It's kind of like how we are before we were ever converted, where we had a hunger for the truth, where we had a hunger for the word. And we wanted to know what was true and what was not true. So this man, he wanted to hear the good news from them, to hear the word of God. And as we continue, but Elymas, the magician, for that is the meaning of his name, opposed them, seeking to turn the proconsul away from the faith. Bar-Jesus, aka Elymas the magician, was trying to lead Sergius Paulus astray. And in order to do that, he was trying to prevent Saul, who is of course Paul, from preaching the good news to him, as do all false prophets of today. And we see it everywhere. So many false prophets that they try to prevent people from receiving the truth, from hearing the word of God, from receiving the good news. But Saul, who was also called Paul, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked intently at him and said, "You son of the devil, you enemy of all righteousness, full of all deceit and villainy, will you not stop making crooked the straight paths of the Lord?" Paul was filled with the Holy Spirit. And we all know that the Holy Spirit gives us the words to say. Being filled by the Holy Spirit, we look at everyone who's ever been filled with the Spirit of God, like Samson. Like, we look at many people like that and how they did so many things because the Holy Spirit worked through them. And here we see it right now. Elymas tried to prevent them from preaching to Sergius Paulus, but the Holy Spirit filled Paul. Paul was filled with the Holy Spirit. And that being done, he confronted Elymas. And note how he called him the son of the devil, how he was the enemy of all righteousness. False prophets do nothing but try to lead people away from God. And now behold, the hand of the Lord is upon you, and you will be blind and unable to see the sun for a time. Immediately, mist and darkness fell upon him, and he went about seeking people to lead him by the hand. So the work of the Holy Spirit, Elymas was blinded. He got blind. And it's kind of ironic when you think about it, because Paul, before he was a Christian, when he became born again, the scales fell from his eyes, where he was no longer spiritually blind. Likewise, right here, you see Elymas become blind, all because he was trying to prevent the good news from being given to the proconsul. And we all know that God is victorious. You cannot stop God from having his will be done. Then the proconsul believed when he saw what had occurred, for he was astonished at the teaching of the Lord. At the end of the day, the proconsul was saved. He received the gospel of Christ. Elymas tried to prevent it, but through the work of the Holy Spirit, he became blind. And Paul delivered the good news, the gospel of Christ, to Sergius Paulus. What do we take from that? Us knowing the truth, us knowing the gospel, we ought to share the gospel with those who have not received it. And of course, there's going to be many false prophets that are like Elymas, where they try to keep you, try to prevent you from sharing the gospel. But you know what? The Holy Spirit is the helper. The Holy Spirit guides us. He guides us into all truth, and he gives us the words to say. Because remember, with man, it's impossible. But with God, nothing's impossible. The gospel will be proclaimed. The gospel will be heard and received. Praise God. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you're new to this channel, please like, share, and subscribe. Let's support each other in Jesus' mighty name. I love y'all, and God bless you all.